By the way, this is real couples therapy right here.
And I always lose, even with the pads.
How's it going? I'm Sheamus, aka the Celtic Warrior, and welcome to Celtic Warrior Workouts. We're here in Orlando, Florida. It's not so sunny Orlando, Florida right now because it's fucking down rain. But that doesn't matter because we have an awesome workout planned with former NXT champion and current SmackDown superstar, Aleister Black.
It's almost like it's, so it's not so sunny. And then you're doing a workout with Aleister Black and it's pouring down. It's almost like it's meant to be.
It's like poetic or something,
it's
right?
It's somewhere, it's like someone is sitting behind their computer watching this and goes, of course it's pouring down. You're doing a workout with Aleister Black. There's no sunlight.
No.
It's kind of like rain.
It's kind of like Aleister actually just Thanos style flicked his fingers and of course made it rain, made it dark, made it kind of grungy, dingy, you know what I mean? But that's okay because we're in your home turf here. We're in your garage gym, actually,
yep.
Which is awesome.
Yes, we are.
And of course, we have his real life wife, Zelina.
What's up? I'm sneaking into another one of your videos.
This is great. This is number three, right?
Number three.
You do a lot of sneaking. There's a lot of sneaking. It's
well,
awesome.
I mean.
But, yeah. Anyway.
Was that a high joke? Or?
No. High jokes, we're past the high jokes. That's what got us into this mess in the first place.
So. Yes.
I've seen your videos on your Instagram account with you and Zelina working out, just baking this poor bag over here to pieces. If this bag of family, I really feel bad for it because it's like it's taking a lot of hits.
It does what it needs to be doing. So,
let's talk about you for a second, right? Obviously, we're both fellow Europeans, Dutch, Irish. Can you tell us about like your career, how you got into wrestling, and how your path has brought you here to WWE, especially for people watching just for the first time.
So I am born in Amsterdam, the Netherlands, as Sheamus says.
Ajax fan?
Ajax fan, absolutely.
Big football soccer fan, just like me.
Big. So I got into wrestling at the age of, I'd like to say 4 or 5.
Wow.
And I never actually grew up watching WWE. I grew up watching Japanese wrestling. I grew up watching European style wrestling, and later on I watched WCW. It wasn't until I was 15 or 16 years old that I saw my first ever WWE pay-per-view, and I was very confused because I never knew that that was a thing.
Right.
I always thought that it was just one thing.
Okay.
Later on, obviously, I understood that there was like, there were multiple promotions going.
Yeah.
But because I was seeing faces that I saw in different companies now working in the WWE, I was like, wait, did they change their name to something?
Yeah.
Because that's that, and then we'll tell you about the exposure that we had. Obviously, it's changed now because I'm there. That we had back in the day when it comes to WWE in the Netherlands.
Okay.
And to me as a kid, when I watched it, it looked like two guys fighting.
Right.
And as soon as my brain started processing this, I was like, I want to do this. I need to do this. So in my child's mind, I started doing martial arts because I thought that's what I was seeing. I thought I was seeing martial arts. So
right.
My parents signed me up for karate. My parents signed me up for judo. I did kung fu for a little bit. And then I started doing kickboxing. And obviously at the time I started doing kickboxing, I hadn't realized that what I was watching on television in terms of professional wrestling, that was not what I was practicing, luckily.
That's great though, because like all that background, all that stuff, all the karate and the kickboxing, you incorporate in your style in WWE right now, and that's has made you so different to everybody else who's come in to the main roster. It's such a different style, such a unique style, as well as that, like throwing up those aerial moves as well, like the middle rope springboard.
That you've been on the receiving
end. I've taken it quite a few times, to be honest. Like, where's he going? How's he doing that? Looking for rocket boots on here or something. But it's definitely been a huge influence on your career.
Yes.
And that's
yes, it has, man.
Definitely paid off. I want to ask you a question though, because
sure.
I watched a lot of wrestling. I wasn't the same thing, like being in Ireland, we had Screen Sport. And Eurosport. Is that where you saw the
Eurosport.
Japanese wrestling?
Yes, Eurosport.
Eurosport.
That's something that we only understand.
That's right. If you're European and you're in our age bracket, you definitely know what we're talking about.
Oh, yes. The goal was always to become a professional wrestler. That was always the number one goal. So by the age of 15, I got the opportunity to train with people who were trained by NWA Hammerlock at the time in the Netherlands, in the Hague.
Because Finn Balor was NWA in the UK.
But this was, I think this was, these were not the guys that were training at NWA Hammerlock.
Okay.
These were guys from the Netherlands who also wanted to be a professor, went over to NWA Hammerlock, did a training course with them, and then came back to the Netherlands and started teaching in the Netherlands. So actually from that, in that little place, it started kind of, the ball started rolling. And I started when I was 15, and I had my first match for that company at age 17.
Wow.
And I do not want to watch that match back.
Trust me, I don't want to watch any of my first year matches back.
Yet. I don't want to watch my matches back now, but.
That's true. I get days like that. Oh, yeah.
Actually, from that point on, the goal was just, the one thing that I always kept in my head as I was doing this is, you got to think globally, not locally. If you keep your mindset on just focused on being in this one promotion that promotes locally, you're not going to expand. So my goal was immediately, the biggest goal that I set for myself was going to Japan.
Right.
It took me around 8-9 years to get to Japan. So when I got there, I was like, well, this is obviously the biggest my career is ever going to get.
Right.
And funny enough, it just started rolling more and more and more and more. And all of a sudden I was like a mainstay name in the United Kingdom. And Japan kept asking me back more and more. And then North America started booking me, and I made debuts for companies like Pros and Gorilla and Evolve.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden I get an email from Drake, NXT referee Drake. And he's like, hey, so William Regal is looking for you. And I'm like, that's interesting. And then Cassius Ohno reached out to me as well. And he said, like, hey, can you give me your number? I'm gonna give you your number too. And from there, I got invited to Manchester. This was back in 2015, the end of 2015. I got invited to Manchester to come and talk with them. And they wanted to see me in the ring with Killian Dane at the time. And me and Killian Dane just kind of wrestled each other for a couple minutes. And I guess they liked what they saw. And they, 3-4 months later, I got the call, and they were like, hey, would you like to join us? So.
That's awesome.
Yep.
Because I remember, actually, I don't know if it was a TV or maybe European tour. I remember like Triple H mentioning to me, and I was like, yeah, I definitely heard of you before, especially, you know what I mean? And
oh, really?
Yeah, and he's like, Regal
was telling me.
No, Regal, this is going back a couple of years, because anytime someone will come in the European scene, like,
the Europeans get asked about it, yeah.
Yeah.
I have this philosophy that, wrestlers age the way dog years go. So 1 year in our life is basically the same as 7 years, because everything goes so incredibly fast. And I feel that we age differently, because obviously, we take such a beating, and then we have to keep up with our peak performances, as that's why we're here today, to show you a part of those peak performances. Our lives intertwine so different than I don't like to use the word regular human beings, because we're all special in our own ways.
Yeah.
But for people who do not do this, our lives are so incredibly different that I feel that sometimes where even from the point where I started in NXT to go into SmackDown, it feels like it was like that. And my call up was obviously a quick one, because I wasn't scheduled to be called up yet.
Okay.
It was a last minute decision.
Yeah, because I saw the vignettes that they ran, which was like January or December or something, and then all of a sudden, right, and they, obviously then they brought you, Ricochet,
Tommaso,
Johnny came up as well,
all in that
bunch, which took everybody by surprise.
Yeah, we were like, I remember very Saturday in this very gym, I was just done, and I had a NXT live event that night, and it was 11:30, and I'm thinking to myself, I don't have to leave until 1. I'm just gonna take a little 45-minute nap,
Of course. Take them when you can.
Oh yeah. We don't get many. We don't get a lot of sleep. So I had my phone placed next to me, and I'm starting to doze off, and my phone goes, and it's Coach Bloom, and I'm like, what does Bloom want?
Yeah.
It's like,
Coach. What have I done now?
Hey, Coach Aleister. I'm like, yeah. So what are you doing? I'm like, I'm laying on the couch, Coach, getting ready for tonight's live event. Oh. Well, I got some news for you. I'm like, you're firing me. as a joke. He's like, something like that. I'm like, no. He's, this Sunday, you're flying to, I can't remember where you flew to because it was...
Yeah, I know.
I think that's somewhere. How it works. Yeah, because they flew us somewhere where we were not making our debut deliberately so that we could... You know, was it Tennessee? Because like they didn't want us to be seen by fans landing on the airport. They wanted to keep it, you know, be a surprise.
So they flew you in a different airport and then get your rental car and then throw.
Yes. So he's like, this Sunday you're flying to Tennessee.
Thanks,
Monday. Thanks, wife. This Monday you make your debut on Monday Night Raw and Tuesday on SmackDown. I'm like, you still there? And I like, do you bleep noises when I make curse words?
Yeah, Ray, you can bleep. Ray can bleep noises. So, it's very infant.
My exact sentence was, get the f*** out. Because I was like, no way. And as soon as that was done, I had to go to the live because I couldn't sleep anymore.
Yeah.
Obviously, after that, I was just like, I called her up. And I was like, well, we'll be traveling together from now on because I'm going to Raw and SmackDown. And it was, and like, the funny thing is, you know, Hunter always talks about how quick it goes and it can be like that, but it literally is that. It can go like that. I mean, you went from your FCW days to quickly went to the main roster as well, and it happens like this, and before you know, you're standing in a garage here in Orlando, Florida.
It's pissing rain outside.
Oh, it stopped already.
Already.
I think because my mood got brighter as we're talking, the rain kind of like...
The weather changed.
Got to get back into this so it will start raining again at some point.
And then you go to WrestleMania. How does
moving
up then WrestleMania?
Yeah. I wrestled you.
Yeah, all about that. Holy shit!
Should I lead this or do you got it? Yeah.
Oh my God! Yeah. WrestleMania.
There is a good 15 seconds of WrestleMania while my arms are behind the ropes. Cesaro is swinging Ricochet round and round. I understand it. Do not say sorry.
Tell Zelina not to come after me.
It was just, but the visual of that is that when that camera zooms back and you're just pounding my chest. I remember standing there going, God. And then I kind of like look behind me and I see Ricochet still going. And I'm like, okay, he's still going. Oh, God.
I had the Tron actually. It was funny. I think Ricochet was hating his life at that point.
At that point, he must have taken at least like 70 swings.
At least. Tony was Cesaro was a.
It was a rare form.
Very rare form. He hadn't done that swing in a while. But
yes.
Yeah, it was awesome. Like that was such an awesome WrestleMania.
It was a great WrestleMania. I honestly like that group of individuals. I couldn't have made a better debut.
That was great.
Fantastic. Same time next year?
Let's do it. All right. Let's do it again. Let's book it. Let's book it right now. What's the most embarrassing song on your playlist?
Oh, that has to be some dance European, some European dance thing. It's not worse than that. Like as a European, I like rhythm. I like good music. And as much as I like metal, black metal and hardcore,
yeah.
I was raised on dance music because I'm Dutch.
Yeah.
I wouldn't say we invented dance music, but we definitely played a big part in dance music. So there's definitely a few dance tracks in my playlist that people would go like, really? We work out together. I've allowed her to create her own playlist. So every once in a while we'll get a Nicki Minaj song and I get a tweet about it. So I'm like,
Our Aaliyah, right?
Aaliyah, yes, you remember. Yeah.
Who would be your ultimate training partner? Who would you love to train with more than anybody? Who would be your like dream? People always ask that in WWE, and I've asked that question many times, but to go to the gym and train with someone, like whether it's MMA, whether it's like bodybuilding, wherever. Like,
I'm gonna give an answer, and it might sound a bit cliche, but the reason why is because he's had such an influence on bringing MMA to the map of the Netherlands, Bas Rutten.
Yeah.
And also because he's a very eccentric individual, but eccentric in the best of ways. And just his training methods, because I follow some of his training methods online, because he just has like insane workouts, and he just seems like he's a very, very fun human being, very thought through human being to be around with, and I would love to train with him, and awesome. Him obviously showing me around 10 gazillion things that I don't know.
So, what's the workout today?
So we are going to start today with a light circuit because I don't like stretching when I'm cold.
Okay.
So I'm gonna do something that is literally the path of least resistance, literally, okay. But just to get your body flowing and get all your ligaments warmed up and kind of like get in there ready in the motion of where we're gonna start striking. Right. Nothing is explosive. Everything is on the calm down. So I literally want you to just like gentle move. I'm gonna give you 5 exercises and we're only gonna do it for a minute.
Okay.
And even if you during that minute start to feel strainy, so just let the exercise go. Okay. It's all about getting comfortable in that in what we're doing. After that, we'll stretch for a good 5 to 10 minutes,
okay.
Which I'm assuming is not gonna be, you know, shown. And after
that,
we'll
start
5 to 10 minutes of stretching. And then after that, we'll start with a 3-round back system where we start with a combination of we start with a 2 combination, and then a 3 combination, and a 4 combination, and all within a minute. So the minute, the first minute is 2 combination, the third minute is a 3 combination, and the fourth minute is a 4 combination.
Okay.
So,
great.
Third minute, sorry. I'm rolling over my own tongue. And then after that, we'll start with some pad workout and with the bag, and it's just a lot of combination work.
Okay.
Lastly, we'll have the 30-30-30, as I call it, which is a 30-second active period where you're active on the back for 30 seconds.
Right.
After that 30 seconds, you go and do a body type workout that you want to do, whether that's squats, burpees, crunches, push-ups, whatever you want, pull-ups, whatever's available for you,
right.
And then you have a 30-second break. Now you think to yourself, oh, 30-second break. Once you get to the fourth and fifth round, you'll be like, oh boy, yeah. And it's because it all comes down to your own intensity. So you can make it as easy for yourself or as hard on yourself. And I feel the reason why I'm doing it like that is when we're out there in the ring, we have a lot of like explosive dynamics. We have something where we speed up and we slow down. And obviously when you're rocking and rolling, you know how much it takes out your system.
Yeah.
It gasses your system out completely. And then you have maybe 15 to 20 seconds where your body can kind of like adapt again before you have to go again. So I base that whole workout on exactly that. And we're probably gonna go around 10 to 15 rounds, usually go 30 rounds. But because there's 3 people and there's more people at the same time, and I
right.
want to give you a snippet of what I do as opposed to give you the whole thing time wise, because 30 rounds of a minute and a half is a lot of time.
Awesome.
So let's go do a little circuit.
Let's go do a bit.
We're going to start with a minute of battle rope. Obviously, myself, Zelina, and Sheamus are going to divide themselves over which exercise they want, as long as at the end of the minutes that we're running, we've done all the exercises. So, minute of band pulls, just whatever you want to do. You can pull them up high, you can pull them to the middle, you can pull them down low, you can do them all 3, that doesn't matter, as long as you have that movement. Shoulder hangs, this is Sean Hayes, for those of us who've been in NXT, this is a Coach Hayes special. You just hang, you pull your shoulders backwards up, and it's nice and gentle, and back. And if you've done 4 or 5, put your feet down for like 3-4 seconds, right back up, and continue until the minute is finished.
Okay.
Kettlebell swing, again, I don't want this to be strenuous. You can grab the lightest, it's about the motion, not about the weight with this one. Nice and deep, forward, very basic exercise. And just a minute of that. Plank position, make sure you can see the timer. Every 5 seconds, just a really light, gentle breathe in, push up. And obviously, battle ropes for the last minute, or the first minute, or the third minute, whatever you want. Position yourself in, and I like to switch every 30 seconds, so if I do a minute, that means that there's only one switch. Top hands, switch after a minute. Just switch your grips. And it's, again, it's a minute, nothing strenuous, just keep it easy. Thank you.
do that around 20 times, 8, 10, and 20.
You hear anybody give me the heavier bath? The bath's over here.
How's that? Yes. We're gonna start in the bag now. I'm gonna set the timer. We're all gonna hit around 3 minutes on the bag, but we're gonna switch in and out. This is all still quite calm. This is just to get our mind ready into boxing. So first thing we're doing is we're gonna go three rounds in the bag, three rounds in a minute, and every round we go, we're gonna add a strike. So the first we start with a two combination. So anything from just a simple 1-2 combo, or a hook and a cross, or a hook and a low kick, everything is possible, whatever you want, but it's just to kind of prime your body to do it. Then the second round, a strike gets at you, you can do three combination, and the last round is a four combination. Scary seeing a guy that's 280 pounds probably. Hit that back that hard.
Four combination. Just play around. Don't go excessively hard. Just play around with it. Stand. Go. You want to do with a liver shot and a low kick. two, three, four. Straight, straight, straight. Straight, straight. There you go. Come on. 1, 2, liver, low kick. Come on. Liver with the left. There you go. That's it. That's the one. Good. Beautiful combo. Come on. Oh, come on. Pull it in. There you go. There you go. You right?
Let's breathe. Yeah. So in the Netherlands we have a saying, verandering van spijs doet eten, which basically means if you change the spices of your food, you'll eat more because it tastes better, because you're hitting different taste buds. Sheamus is telling me how much he's enjoying this right now, because obviously, you know, the way he looks, he's a guy who lifts a lot of weight. So he hadn't boxed in a while, so the first thing he told me is like, man, I'm having so much fun with this. It's because when you do one thing continuously, strenuous over time, your body can kind of get dull to it, and it doesn't motivate you as much anymore. So even if you are a weightlifter watching Sheamus' channel, sign up for a local kickboxing class. Just do it once. And you don't have to do it ever again. Just kind of like going, hey man, that was fun. Just something a little different for you. And also, being cardiovascular more helps your lifts in the long run. We'll start out very simple. I have Thea in front of me. We'll just start moving around a little bit. We're gonna go for just a simple, just a 1-2 combination with jab and a cross. So whenever you just put my gloves up or my pads up, just kind of move around and kind of play around with it a little bit. She has to keep her guard up at all times because I can kind of come in, boom, throw them back up. And I'll tell them to throw a 1, a 2, and a low kick.
On
this side? Yeah, boom. And we go again.
Oh, you want to go both?
Yes, I do.
By the way, this is real couples therapy right here. They work all their issues out right in this room with these pads.
And I always lose, even with the pads. So, even with Sheamus, I'm telling him to throw his guard up, keep his guard good, and kind of relax on his body. Relax on his, because I can see he's kind of sturdy. He's like, so I'm going to relax your body. And every time I throw up, perfect. And try to tip on your toe on that last one. Throw your hip in, so when you strike, you get this nice little pivot. And when you strike, you put so much of your body weight into that one strike, and you don't want to extend all the way, so when you strike, you want to kind of have a half extend here, so when you have to follow through, that's where the money comes from. Okay. But you never want to extend your arm fully.
Okay, so it'll be like, boom.
Yes, and turn that in just a little bit more. Yeah, there we go. Just give me that cross. Give me a good one. Give me a good one. Give me a good one. There we go. All right, give me a good 1-2. And we're going to play around a little bit, so just be light in your feet. So we're going to do a one, two, come with the low kick, three. And make sure that you twist your body in with your low kick.
Okay. Boom. So it's here. So it's like
one, two, switch your stands up.
Boom.
Yeah.
Is that right? It's been a while since I did this in my practice.
Are you standing your stands? Do you have a regular or do you have a... Okay, good. So when you do that second one, it's 1, 2, you kind of slide in. There comes the low kick in. Throw your hips in there as well.
So 1, 2.
I really move your foot forward with that cross. It's 1, 2, 3. Move that foot forward just a slight bit.
1.
Move it forward.
2.
Yeah, and now hit that low kick. And try to put your weight into it. So when you hit, 1, 2, you're already kind of down.
Okay.
You stand. Yeah?
Okay.
But all of this, especially technique, it takes an awful lot of time. And clearly, I don't have the best technique, but it takes practice, practice, practice to get somewhere. And you see here, he's standing too far away from it. He's trying to hit it with the knuckles. I shouldn't want to come close. And when I come really close, I really twist those hips in, took the foot all the way out. That's better. That's a good one. Everyone always has one that they're better with the other. Yeah. All right, come on. Let's get five good ones. We want you with the low kick. Come on. Try to go down.
Yeah, I got you. Sure.
No, it's fine. When you kick me in the hip, you want to kind of angle it down. You want to get me right there. You feel that? Yeah. Even that one. If we stand like this and come in, even that was like, ugh.
Yeah.
Yeah, you want to angle it down.
Okay. Try not to fuck kick your shin off.
Okay. Go down.
Yeah.
Big low. Yeah, there we go.
Maybe it's better if I kick my right now.
That's okay.
Oh, that's better for me.
Yep. Same thing, you're just gonna go back and forth with one another. So, same thing, gloves up. It's just gonna throw a 1-2 with a low kick. You're gonna throw a 1-2 with a low kick on our stuff.
Right.
Yeah?
Ready?
Yeah.
Go.
One. And go move. Yeah, there you go. There you go. Three. Four. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Okay, good.
Yeah.
We're just gonna keep going.
We're just
going to
keep going around
circles
like that.
We're just going to keep going.
All right. So it's a 1-2 with a big third. Boom. There we go. Come on. 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 So now with Zelina, Zelina's a little bit more trained to absorb my strikes. So.
No domestic disputes, of course.
No.
This is just in the garage.
On the gloves and the pads. So, see how she moves in with those strikes?
Yeah.
So if I strike, see she comes
in. She's coming in, I'm
hitting my gloves, yeah.
Yeah.
Feel that?
Yeah, it's great.
Sometimes that eliminates the usage of like having to use
sweat just going everywhere, sweat flying all over the place.
All right, last set, best set. 30 seconds of bag workout. 30 seconds of active movement, which can be burpees, squats, crunches, push-up. I don't care as long as you stay active. You can shadow box for 30 seconds for all I care, but test yourself. And then you have 30 seconds of rest. But I can guarantee you one thing, those 30 seconds of rest are gonna actually at one point become more irritating and annoying than they are going to be nice. Today we're gonna take you to a multitude of rounds. Usually I go 30 rounds.
Today we're gonna go around 5 to 10 rounds just because I wanna give you guys a snippet of this. Just make sure that you hydrate because this can be a killer. So make sure that in between you have your specific hydrations with carbs in it, or even your Gatorade, your water at least, but keep hydrating. Go!
Switch.
That is awful. In the best of ways.
See that? I'm not even doing this just like messing around. My hands are a little shaky.
Boos.
Hell yeah, Jimmy.
You can see why Aleister Black has rose so quickly to the ranks from NXT as NXT champion right up to the main roster in SmackDown, because he's never complacent. His style is different, it's unique. He's incorporated all the martial arts he trained as a child and integrated into his WWE style, which is the way the business is going these days, especially with UFC being so popular. Mate, you know, these are things that people don't see. They see the matches in the ring, but it's the hard work that goes in the background, behind the scenes. It's also great that your wife is also, Zelina is also a WWE superstar, and the fact you guys work out together and push each other. That's a real partnership right there. Guys, thank you so much. This has been absolutely awesome. This is a it's a great inspiration for Brave Change. And this is the Blackout, Aleister Black Blackout Workout.
Well, thank you so much for joining us in our little gym. This is a good part of how I work out. Obviously, there's tons of variables, as I showed you throughout the workout, that you can work with. If you are someone who's looking for a nice change of pace, guys, just try this out. You'll have a lot of fun. I guarantee you, if you keep doing this, the calories will fly, because it's such a draining workout. It burns so much for your endurance. Even if you are a professional athlete on a different discipline, I would still invite you to try something this out, because everybody needs cardiovascular work. You can see Sheamus, despite his size, has a lot of lung capacity, because Sheamus is also not someone who predominantly lifts weights. Massive explosive strength, which is, you can only build that by prolonged cardiovascular workout. And my man here just followed us perfectly in his footsteps, in our footsteps, and he absolutely killed this workout. So thank you for having
me. Thank you, man. Thank you so much, Aleister. Again, inspiring a lot of people. All you need, guys, you don't need an expensive gym membership or go to the gym that's 30 minutes away. Stick a heavy bag up in your garage or anywhere in your room or somewhere beside
you. Buy a barbell and some weights and you're good to go. You're good to go.
Use that timer. Keep switching it up. Thank you, Zane. Awesome.
Thank you, man.
Tough as nails. Till next time.
Shower time.
Brave change.
Brave change.
How's it going? I'm Sheamus, aka the Celtic Warrior, just after doing an awesome blackout workout with former NXT champion and WWE superstar Aleister Black and WWE superstar Zelina Vega. Tell them the Brave Change, guys.
Well, as you can see by the puddles of sweat that we've deposited in our little humble garage gym, this was one for the records. I brought out the big guns because I knew Sheamus was coming, and I can't take it easy on Sheamus, so this was definitely one that you want to watch.
Video coming to my Celtic Warrior workout channel soon. Subscribe now and see you first.